What do you guys hope to accomplish at the state level?
Right now, we put forward an amendment initiative to put before the people so they could vote to actually criminalize abortion by amending the state constitution. The ACLU has protested that. So that language is going to be thumped by the Supreme Court to say, hey, you know what, you're not allowed to prohibit abortion as murder because we think the Constitution says that you're allowed to stab a child in the face. And it doesn't. Just don't say that. The Supreme Court is just dead wrong on that whole thing.
Jeremy.
But we have to actually challenge them on that. No one challenges them on that. They always put forward these things that flop underneath the legs, underneath the ruling.
Run that by me. Yeah.
So nobody challenges the Supreme Court ruling that there's a right to abort your child in the Constitution. There isn't a right to murder your children in the Constitution.
Correct.
So what the pro-life legislators do is they write these bills that sort of like don't challenge abortion itself, mm-hmm. but sort of come up with some way of looking like you're challenging abortion. Like, if you're going to get an abortion, you got to be 30 miles away from a hospital where you have visiting privileges, which is tantamount to saying, if you're going to molest a child, you need to be 30 miles away from a daycare center. If these legislators think abortion's murder, they wouldn't be putting forward bills to say, like, when you murder somebody, you got to murder it with our health care license. They'd be saying, but no one murders.
Just out of curiosity, and believe you me, I'm not arguing with you.
Yeah.
I just want to understand. Why don't you guys use your energy, money, all that stuff at the state level instead of federal?
Well, we
because
we
if the state passes it, what's going to happen next year?
If
it's going to get overturned in the...
That would be interposition. So if Mary Fallon thought abortion was murder, mm-hmm. not just said, but like felt it and believed it, mm-hmm. and she got a referendum or a bill or something from the people or from the legislator that said, we're going to put an end to child sacrifice in Oklahoma. And she signed it. Now clearly, Obama or the next guy or lady send in, you know, federal troops or whatever. It's like, no, you can't prohibit that. This is a constitutional right, right? She has to stand her ground and say, no, in the state of Oklahoma, we have passed laws protecting all human beings equally from murder. And she'll have to stand her ground. And we as her constituents, as the people behind her, will have to support her. But that, I mean, if she doesn't do that, it's just sort of like this posturing.
That's her duty to do that.
Yeah.
That's her office. So you almost see it as a state's rights. State's got to stand up.
It is a state's right.
Okay. But, I just want to make sure I understand.
But it forces that federal thing. Now, if there was a federal amendment to abolish abortion, that'd be great. The problem is the 14th Amendment already says that no person shall be deprived the right to life, liberty, you know, without due process of law. And all these innocent human beings that are alive, that's why they kill them, because they're alive and growing, and we don't want them to continue to grow. They're all being deprived the right to live. And so there's already an amendment in the United States Constitution that prohibits abortion. But you've got this tyrannical ruling of the Supreme Court, and then the subsequent ruling saying that that was right, saying no, the Constitution protects the killing of children, and it doesn't. So a governor just needs to say, listen, I have taken an oath to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States of America. It says that no one will be deprived of life. We have these freestanding child sacrifice centers and the dispensing of these various poisons in our culture that deprive people of life. We are not going to do that here. We're going to hold to the rule of law, and we're going to enforce it. She can do that, and she has the power, but she has to be willing to stick her neck out.
Gotcha.
She needs to bow to the actual law against murder instead of this judicial tyranny to allow murder in the womb. But the mechanism, the actual practical mechanism, so you don't think we're just a bunch of people with T-shirts and pamphlets and stuff, is that the amendment initiative that we put forward that they're dumping needs to be picked up by a senator or a representative who will then turn around and say, listen, they're not allowed to do their citizen initiative. I'm going to put it forward as a referendum.
Right.
I'll put it forward as a bill. Because with 85% being pro-life, saying that abortion's murder, they ought to be able to pass it. If they don't pass it, the one thing keeping abortion legal in Oklahoma is the pro-life legislature. So we got that on that side. The other side is to let all the people in Oklahoma know that. All these guys. They're the reason abortions. Yeah.
Vote them out.
Vote them out. Get rid of them. Get rid of the pro-lifers, put in abolitionists.
Yeah. People that want to follow God.
Like, just anybody who comes to talk.